Okay, so the problem that new players have is that they're constantly trying to pull themselves forward to their hips. And they're, you can tell, they're really struggling really hard to pull and move, but they're holding it all the way to the back of their movement. The proper way to do it is to grab and hold, and you're going to want to make this motion like you're actually running, but you want to let go at the bottom of your arc, at the bottom of your arc here. And that's what's going to give you that gliding forward movement. Just grab, hold, let go here as you're going down, and you'll get to maintain that movement forward. I mean, heck, you can even grab and let go just a little snap. It's all about that momentum and when you're, how much momentum you have when you're releasing. So I can move to the side with a quick little snap and move, you know, 3-4 feet to the side just by snapping like that. Which gives you a lot of advantage because you can pop around corners and immediately have your aim up here. Glide around a corner. So to move fluidly, you're going to alternate doing that. You can do it slowly here. As you're releasing, you're bringing your next hand up. And eventually, you'll be able to just... This is a full speed run. You can run a little faster than that, but it obviously takes the extra effort. This is about how fast most pro players can run. You can run like that to the side too, keeping a look ahead of you, moving it in front of you, back. So to move backwards really quickly, you hold the menu button on your chest and flick it away from you. You could do that with both hands, run backwards, or you can still see behind you and keep an eye on it. Shoot running backwards. Some people say that they have a problem moving and shooting. With pro movement, you can still move and shoot pretty accurately. It just takes that little bit of practice. You can move forward, shoot accurately with one hand. Hell, you can dodge around corners, shoot two hands. There's also the option to press this left trackpad while you have it held up, and that activates with pro movement, the trackpad movement. But as you can tell, it's not very fast. It's mainly meant for, like, if you're long range shooting with a rifle, you can peek around corners with that. But really, even with the rifle, I still prefer to just pull, move my hand, pull back, pull, move my hand, pull back. Because using this trackpad movement to move back and forth, it takes a second to activate, and then it can kind of interfere with some of the other functions of the game. So. Tell here, like especially, they still haven't fixed this yet. You can accidentally pull out your mag while you're trying to activate this. So, okay, the next part is vaulting over stuff. So, I guess technically it's climbing in general. So we're gonna start talking about climbing now. With climb stuff, you're gonna put your hand over it, and you'll see this little yellow activated button. When that comes on, you can press and hold the menu button. Oh, turn this way so you can kind of see. You can press and hold the menu button, and you can lift yourself up by going down. Sometimes to get over stuff, you're going to need to completely, like see here, I can't get over it until I move it all the way down, almost by my feet, bend over. You have to lift your feet up enough to get on top of the object. Let's just try it again. Grab and hold on top, bring it all the way down. You're going to have to crouch even a little bit, and you can bring yourself on top of an object. You get good enough, going with speed, you can vault all the way over an object to get to better vantage points. So this box is a good example of how you can vault yourself all the way up onto an object. Okay, so climbing. So like right here, anything that has a top edge usually can be climbed. Guns can get in the way of climbing a little bit, so sometimes you almost want to put that away. Okay, so here, I can reach here, climb on top of this. Oop, a little bit of glitching there. I can grab there, grab here, and you can climb all the way on top of stuff. All right, now that's the slow version of the climb. What I'm gonna show you next is one of the things that always freaks out new players a little bit, but is one of the most fun parts of the game, and that is jumping. So to jump, I can climb all the way up there to the top of this building pretty easily. What you do is you see how you can activate the holding mechanism on the ground. You want to press the menu button on the ground, keep holding it, lift up to the top of your range, and say, I'm still holding the menu button. You know you're working. If you keep holding it, you can lift yourself up off the ground. I'll also talk about peeking later. This is a really good way to peek around corners and over stuff. Okay, but to jump, well, just like when you run, you hold the menu button and you let go of the menu button as you're flinging yourself up. So you want to let go of the menu button right about here as you're flinging yourself up, and you'll get a nice little pop there. So I can climb up here, grab the menu button, hold, fling myself up, grab this ledge as I catch the top of it, bring myself up here, keep holding the menu button, and every time you hold the menu button, you lift up, you're resetting how high up you're going. Now I can fling myself off this up to the top of this ledge right here. And I get just climbed all the way from down there. Got this amazing vantage point onto the defensive spawn here. You know, so if you're good enough, you could climb all the way here, get up here, get a really good vantage point. Crouching is also a big part of this game. Okay, next is you can do a crouch, run, and jump. So now we're going to jump to that building. All right, so what you're going to do is get yourself set up on the ledge here. Grab and hold the ledge like you're setting up for a jump. Hold up, and then we're going to jump and run in midair over to that other rooftop. So I'm going to jump and run in midair. And with that, I can leap all the way across this building here. I can sometimes catch this gap right here between these two buildings if I run and jump properly. You need to get a really high jump, and you need to run quickly in midair to be able to leap over that building. The next thing is peeking. So, let's see. We can peeking around corners and peeking over the top of things is a way that you can get a really good vantage point. So, as an attacker on this map, Sands, a lot of times, let's see. One of my favorite defensive spots on Sands is above this building over the B side over here. So I'll run all the way back up and around to the top of that building. So if I want to attack that spot there, you're going to want to get a good vantage point. So crouching down, just exposing your head here. This happens in game. You can go all the way down to laying down if you need to. Although, of course, that makes it a little difficult to maneuver yourself on the ground, which is the point. But here, you're just exposing tiny part of your head, all right? Same thing if you're trying to peek over a ledge from this backside. So to be able to peek over the top of things, this corner here, you can jump up, grab the ledge, and then you can peek over the top. So this is a really good maneuver on a lot of things, such as peek over the top of something from an angle that they might not expect you to be peeking from. Again, as I said before, you can come sliding around corners, right? Already aiming. Can't even get back here a little further. Just catch the edge of it and already be aiming at them. And then move back, just fling back. That's all you need to know, just to show some advanced climbing here really quick. Coming from the attacker's start, one of my favorite places to go is up here on top of this building. So you're going to ground leap from here, and you're going to ground leap up this ledge, catching the ledge as you go up on every spot, and just keep lifting yourself up. And then you're going to run a little bit and ground leap up to this last part and get all the way on top. So once you learn how to run and jump properly, this whole map is your playground. You can reach every... I've gotten all the way back up to there, top of this building, top of these buildings. It opens up entirely new attack routes instead of just staying along the ground to both points. You can ride along that ledge up there. You can come along this side to this building, attacking a point down from that side, and you can catch them off guard, because until people learn how to do this game a little better, there's going to be a lot of avenues that haven't been taken. I like to come up on this point, check in, come all the way around to this right side. Let's see, there's still some bugs here. Look down over the top. Got all of A point, all of these roofs that they normally like to cover. There you go. I hope this was a useful introduction to you to movement, and let me know in the comments what you guys think and anything else that you'd like to see. Thank you.